Strati, quindi lui è compromesso.
Esatto. Grazie e buon lavoro.
A first ever gold medal for the U.S. women's gymnastics team leads the Olympic news this morning. But their low scores break COG's transportation system. Lots of folks left without rides at the south side. Live team coverage begins with WSB's Richard Sanger.
At the Atlanta City Hall, Frank Sartor's council general manager, Greg Maddock, has come to meet his Atlanta counterpart.
Tell everybody what stadium are we going to.
But so too have a large group of angry vendors. They've paid the city big license fees and they're losing money.
Well, the problem here is that they've caught the things that they promised that the vendors, the merchants that they will allow us to do, they've not done it. They were supposed to have blocked off a 3-mile radius around the Coca-Cola venue for the merchants to be able to come out and show their wares and everything and allow the people to walk through and come into our areas and shop and visit with us. There's a lot going on in Atlanta. We want to tell you about
and that
it.
Everything is
you.
Not monopolized by the major corporations,
just, that's
where
right.
The smaller people like us suffer.
Yes.
Now, this is what we were told we would be a part of this event.
The Olympic Games.
Now that they have received all our monies and everything, we have been excluded.
We've sold about $500 worth of hot dogs since Friday.
And how much have you invested?
We've invested over $150,000.
The city officials have their hands full. Greg Maddock will have to return another day.
And hopefully when we come out, there will be a chance to let you know what the decision is.
Mayor Bill Campbell's press secretary, Jill Strickland, has come to face the vendors.
The mayor, he's the commissioner who sell to VG Swing all the license. The mayor, he is the head of the commissioner. She know that.
City officials have agreed to meet in private with some of the aggrieved vendors.
People must realize that 80% of the games is still ahead of us. You know, there's still a time to make this successful for everyone.
Give them some time.
So you got time to do what?
Listen, I don't know that we got good. What do you
think? Let's step over a minute. Let's step over here.
Yeah, finally. Tell you guys what's going on real quick so you guys don't get real restless. Tomorrow morning they're gonna probably have a press conference and announce some changes that are gonna try to implement in an effort to try and ease.
It never happened.
Well, okay, we're in here to talk
to the end of this.
The whole city.
We all the one today.
But listen.
The following day, new measures to redirect pedestrians are put to the test.
An American taste sensation.
Traffic is a little bit better, but it's not helping.
How many have you sold today?
I probably sold about 20 hot dogs. We need to do about 10,000 more today.
Thinking that it's going to pick up and it's going to continue to pick up, we're going to do well.
But just doing this together is just a feat that we said we were going to do. We're doing it, and we're not going to leave it until it's done. And that shows our family, our children, that when you make up your mind to do something, you follow it through, even through the adversities.
Vendors now are having to get creative, and we're getting carts, as we've done here. We've commandeered a cart, and we've modified it for our own product. And now we're going to go mobile, hit the streets, and we're going to go where the people are, because the people aren't coming to us.
Katrina Fraser and Maggie White have also taken to the streets with their team. The Australian Tourist Commission are giving away everything from rubber boomerangs to Aussie neck coolers.
So you can pick any colour you like, wear it proudly.
We will. We
you have to be in Australia in about 4 years.
Where's Ray? How's he doing?
In the land of the hustlers, anything goes.
We've come down to the realisation that we have to do anything in order to attract attention. You can't afford to be very quiet, shy and retiring.
Okay, you come and see us.
We're also deciding on the fact as to whether we actually bring in a koala suit. So, all these ideas that we sort of put in the past, we're finding that we're having to unearth them again. And, sort of say, this is it. This is how we're going to create attention. Because we're dealing with so many people.
All yours, for free. All yours.
Oh, hi, Karen. It's Maggie. How are you? That's very well, thank you. I don't know if you can help or not. I've just been speaking to Rodney in New York, and I understand you have a selection of koala suits at the helpline. Are you requiring them over the next few days? Okay. Why don't you... Can you parcel them up and send them down to us?
In a blink of the human eye, the undefeated, undisputed champion of the 4x100 meters, the United States of America...
USA swimmers push the medal count for the home...
The games have reached the halfway point. Atlanta's Olympic workforce is holding up well. At the Atlanta City Depot, the street cleaners are changing shift.
What's happening here now, we're getting ready, we call it changing of the guard. The day shift is getting off and the night shift is coming on. Getting their tools, getting their trucks, everything they need for the night shift. Our shifts go 24 hours.
We're gonna rock and roll, y'all. We're gonna rock and roll.
Bye-bye.
On this night, Atlanta seems at peace. Things at last are going well. By 1 a.m. on a sultry morning, the crowds have relaxed around Centennial Olympic Park.
We just have the immediate reaction with that sound effect, and then we realized, no, that's not, these people are hurt, and there were people screaming and yelling. And then we heard, of course, people started yelling things about bombs, and from there...
Around 1:15 this morning is when this explosion went off in Olympic Centennial Park.
Explosion apparently at the base of a light tower.
Many, many people.
Federal officials have told CNN it appears to be a pipe bomb.
Atlanta is shut down right now. You can't drive down there.
We have not been able to independently confirm that, but the FBI has indeed confirmed that the first explosion was caused by a bomb.
That it was left in front of the soundstage, and that he did see some kind of flash before it went off.
Shrapnel
flying metal through the air seems to be one of the causes of an awful lot of the injuries.
I got to tell you, it's a very eerie situation down here, standing on the street with people almost in a daze. Some people from news organizations, obviously, here, but other people who were in the park.
On a vu cette explosion tout à l'heure et il y a moins de panique, hein, il n'y a plus de panique, les gens sont beaucoup plus calmes maintenant.
Ça va ?
Everyone has been jolted from their sleep. At the press centre, the game's organisers and a shaken mayor gather to respond.
Clear the stage.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? My name is A.D. Frazier. I'm the Chief Operating Officer with the Atlanta Committee for the Olympic Games. Can you hear me now? We'd like to start with a decision by the IOC and ACOG, which will be announced by Mr. Carrard, and then we'll discuss the specific events having taken place this morning.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. We at the International Olympic Committee are all, with our hearts, with the families of the victims of the tragic incident which occurred tonight.
With the city cordoned off, the street cleaners have returned to base.
I'm sad because there are some folk that are hurt. All we can do is pray for them and wish them well and hope that people around the world would learn to love one another and value lives a little more than they do.
With the dawn comes the full shock of the night's events. Atlanta's dreams are gone for now.
Meanwhile, we are all agreed the games go on. We will take every necessary step to protect the athletes and those who are attending the games.
Things.
Well, pretty quiet. Publicity person's worst nightmare. We're sitting here with no one to communicate with. Also, it's not, I think, a very sensitive thing to do to start to talk about Australia. The thing is that, yes, we are safer than a lot of other destinations, but you see something like this happen and you think, well, there truly we could be in 4 years. But we're here, our koalas look a bit sad. Our suit's stuck in, our koala suit is stuck in... I think it's stuck in security somewhere. I don't know whether we'll get it in. I don't even know whether we'll use it for, if at all, now.
But I thought you were using a long-distance line.
But I was doing it on an 800 number.
They can connect
you. Call the 800 number.
Mark Potter's going to ask him just a couple questions before he gets on for the World News piece.
The next day, Mayor Bill Campbell is to appear on America's ABC network.